Hello, my name is Vesna Alexovska. I have Gaucher disease type 1 and I'm from North Macedonia. For more than 10 years, I've been working as a patient advocate. I enrolled the first training group of EOPATI because I wanted to learn more. I wanted to understand the world of clinical trials. I wanted to be able to communicate better with doctors and researchers and talk about patient needs in the way that they can understand me. So EOPATI is very important to me because it helped me in building futures for many families with rare diseases, not just in my country, but internationally also.
Hello, my name is Mark van Griepen. I was diagnosed with Parkinson's more than 60 years ago. I'm originally Dutch, but I live in Scotland nowadays. I was made aware through Parkinson's UK about the EOPATI training course for patient advocacy in medicine development. I applied for the course because I feel it's extremely important that people with an illness are involved in the development of medicine and in the activities of scientists in order to improve the amount of treatment that we can give in the short term for managing an illness and in the longer term towards a cure. One of the main benefits of EOPATI for me has been working with other people who've gone through the course, irrespective of which illness is, share our experiences, get to know each other, and provide mutual support. Thank you.
My name is Robert Joyce, and I've got multiple sclerosis, and I am part of the EOPATI network. I decided to join EOPATI or become a EOPATI fellow because of my experience with other EOPATI fellows, namely Joan Jordan. And I met her at a meeting one day in Dublin, and she told me the huge benefits of being part of EOPATI. And as a result, I decided to do it. And it has been an absolutely amazing experience. I have met countless people who have been through the training, and their experience, expertise in their disease areas has been inspirational. And I have learned not only about the medicine's development process and how complex it is and how long it takes, but I've also learned how important it is for patients to be involved in this journey, the contribution that we can make. And as a result of the training that I have done, I have now been able to work with the Irish health system. I have a researcher in the university in Galway, and I'm also helping studies around the world on how they can incorporate patients better into research. An absolutely fantastic experience and worth every minute that I spent on it. Thank you, goodbye.
Hello, my name is Lotte Klim. I am living with type 1 diabetes. I've been a patient representative in my community for many years. And when I started with being involved in research, I soon discovered that I needed kind of more background into contributing more constructively to the discussions with scientists, with researchers. So by coincidence, I discovered EOPATI and applied for the course. And it's really been lifting the level of our contributions and the voice that we now have in these discussions. It's been the absolute most powerful tools to stand on, and also with the support from all the fellows and in the great network that I now have built up across especially Europe, but also the US and also the other networks that are coming to EOPATI. It's been I can only recommend it.
My name is Sandrine Lavallée. I am a representative of EOPATI Luxembourg. And in 2020, I decided to follow the EOPATI training. So why did I decide to enroll in the EOPATI training? Because I really want to better understand the world of research and also medicine development. Why did I want to better understand? Because I really want to ensure that everything that is done for the patient is done with the patient. And I really want that the voice of the patient, the needs of the patient were taken into account before doing something for the patient. And another point, so why is UPRT important from my perspective? I think the UPRT give a real voice to patients and it considers the patient as a partner. And it was the first time that we were recognized like this. And I think it is really important because it is a question of point of view. If we want to innovate the research, we have to take into account the patient needs. Like this, it will be a win-win research for the researchers, but also for the patient.
Hi, my name is Oriana. I was interested in patient advocacy and I met a Portuguese patient, Eupati Fellow, and I told her that I would like to become more active in patient advocacy, but didn't know how to start. She told me that I would need to start by having training and educate me Eupati. Eupati training allows to obtain a good education in research and therapeutical innovation, and we can get concrete examples about what I can do as patient advocates.
Hello, my name is Delphine Heenan. I'm the mother of a 17-year-old boy who was diagnosed with cancer 8 years ago. When he first relapsed, it was very clear that there was a lack of innovation in the field of pediatric cancers. It became my mission to understand why and to change that. But I soon realized that in order to be able to influence researchers and the industry or the regulators, I had to speak the language and understand the process of the development of new drugs. That's how I decided to enroll in Eupati, and these are the skills that I gained by attending the training.
It's Paula Kruger. I decided to enroll in the Eupati Patient Expert course because I thought the program was really, really interesting. It provided in-depth knowledge, something very different from the other programs that I saw around. And it was also something unique because the organizational structure was very good. To me, Eupati represented the opening of new possibilities in patient advocacy, especially in clinical research. You are equipped with real practical knowledge and you can really make a difference for patients.
Hi there, my name is Joan Jordan. I wasn't diagnosed with MS until I was 36 years of age, and I really felt that I knew nothing about patient advocacy, about how it worked. And once I enrolled in Eupati, I felt like I had leveled up, like as if I was in the game. And really, I had a map. I knew where I was going. I knew where I wanted to go. And it's just been such a boost to my patient advocacy activities and has really helped me make a difference.
I'm Dominique Hammerlink. I'm a Dutch patient expert nowadays. And I enrolled in the Eupati training. I already did quite a lot of patient advising, but I sort of felt like I'm missing the point. And when I read about the Eupati training, I saw that they were answering the questions I had about medicine development. I would learn the language for the other people at the table would be using, and I would understand the whole process of medicine development. And this has helped me develop tremendously. I'm now an expert. I advise from HTA to new drugs, to new medical devices. And it's been a fantastic basis to be at the table and know what you bring.
Hi, my name is Monserrat Hassan, father and CML patient and patient advocate. CML is the chronic myeloid leukemia kind of hematological cancer. I'm living in Barcelona. After being diagnosed with this type of leukemia in 2015, and finding very little information about this CML in Spain, I decided to learn more about the disease and about the involvement of patients in the development, treatment, research on a rare disease like this. As a member of CML Advocates Network, one of the largest umbrella of patient organization, I was able to meet the patient advocates involved in this world for many years before. Now, so wanted to learn more as this. And thanks to them, I discovered Eupati. and do not hesitate to apply to try to be one of the participants in the third cohort of the expert training course for patients. And finally, I was able to enroll it. And neuropathy for me is important. It's really important because it means the opening the door to knowledge of a world of advocacy. Sometimes we don't know even in Spanish how to translate the meaning of advocacy and our patient advocate. And it's not a lawyer, obviously, the first translation. And for me to go there and to know that I need to learn more things in order to be able to try to defend, to fight for our rights, and to be involved in all these processes was really important. And for me, EUPATIS and educational courses are essential to be part in this crazy world of advocacy.